Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to my playlist. And in this playlist, I'm going to cover some JavaScript important interview questions. So if you are preparing for interview, then you can go for these basic interview questions, which you may face in telephony round. This is not for the written round or for the in detailed written round. So if you are just aware about all these questions, then at least you can clear the telephony round or the initial round of a verbal round. Okay, so I'm just covering the basic questions here, like how to create an object, how the JavaScript prototype work, what are the different methods, how to freeze an object, how to deep clone or how to do a shell copy of an object, what are the different types, how we are creating a new object. All these things are actually basic methods, but you should be aware of, because these are the basic questions which you may face in the initial rounds. So how to create an object in JavaScript? You can use the literals, or you can use new object, right, or object.create. So there are different ways of creating a JavaScript object. So here I'm just using the JSON literal to create an object. So another important question is, what is a closure? So closure is having of access to the parent function. So consider that there are nested functions. Function A is returning a function B. So function B is able to store some values which are returned by function A. It can store some values which are coming from function A once the function A has already returned. So closure is a function having access to its parent scope. That's it. That is the definition. So if you have a nested function, function A and function B has access to the scope of function A. And it can store some variables even when the function A has returned. So if you do console.dir function B inside the closure of the function B, you will see that value. How to define a function? So there are different ways of defining a function using anonymous function. You can just assign these functions to some another variable. You can pass one function to another function. That is called a callback mechanism, that when you are returning a function from a particular function. But definition is simple. Here you don't need a function name. Here you need a function name. So what are the different ways to call the function? So this is JSON object. Here I'm calling getLogos function. So what are the different ways of doing it? First, repository.getLogo property, you get the getLogo property and then call that function. Or repository.getLogos, just directly call the function. Or you can call it using call and apply. repository.getLogos.call and apply. So there are different ways of calling a particular function from an object. So this is also important, how we can check the type of an object, what should be the type of null, what should be the type of undefined. All these questions are important. Type of undefined is undefined, type of null is an object. Here you can see the type is number, so it will give you the string expressions in the output, that what is the type. Array.isArray is the new function where you can check array is an actual array or not. A.constructor equal to number, true, okay. Similarly, you can check the type of a function, which should be an object. All these things you can check with this type of object. Similarly, how to implement inheritance like user and admin. You have seen that JavaScript provides a prototypal inheritance, that you declare one function, the function B, function A and function B. Function B can inherit the prototype functions from function A. Consider this user. I have created these two lines. I have created a user prototype. I created a function user, then I added a login functions in the user prototype. Then I created an admin, and in the admin prototype, I assigned a new user object. Okay, so admin's prototype is pointing to the object reference of user. So now you got all the access of the user properties. So admin.prototype.grant access, this new function I created, and I created two objects, admin one and user one, from admin and user. Now I can check admin one is instance of admin, admin one instance of user, and user one dot grant access, because user doesn't have a grant access function, so you will get undefined. Admin has a grant access, admin has a login also. Okay, functional hosting and the variable hosting is a feature of JavaScript. So whatever you declare in the function, you can even call the function before declaring it, like this. Look, I'm calling look function, I'm calling before I even defined it. So JavaScript allow you to call a function before its definition. Okay, so this particular function A will not work because look is not a function, right? Look is a variable. Here look is a function, so this is perfectly working with the function hosting. But this is look is a variable, this is an anonymous function, so you cannot implement the same scenario here. Okay, so in the next video we will talk about more JavaScript interview important questions.